It's date night. But holy cow, is that your face in the mirror or did someone order a pizza with the works? It's all right, because we're here to teach you when it's okay to pop a pimple and when not to. Because if you pop a pimple at the wrong time, you could end up scarring your face for life or even dying. Pro tip, never pop a nose pimple if you value living. Pimples are pretty gross eyesores, and despite being able to put a man on the moon, humanity really hasn't made much progress in the whole preventing acne arena. It doesn't help that we're also fans of putting sugar into literally everything. And all that extra sugar in your body can lead to overproduction of both oil and bacteria. If you want to give your face a break, try ditching sugar first. You might be surprised at the results. It turns out, though, that the body has a mechanism for helping control acne in the first place, and it's called acne. That's right, that big, white, pulsating eyesore that's the only prom date you're getting this year is actually the body's way of trying to prevent something even worse from happening. The pimple itself is caused when bacteria that normally live on the skin make their home inside a pore on your face. These pores contain dead skin cells and natural oils that would normally be shed directly onto the top layer of the skin and whisked away. The resulting lesion, or pimple, is your face's way of giving them an eviction notice. The pustule's job is actually to contain that delicious mix of oil and bacteria and keep it from reaching the surface of the skin and then spreading out into other pores, which can promptly clog up. That's why it's such a bad idea to pop a pimple. All you're doing is causing all of that stuff that created a pimple in the first place to ooze out all over your face and clog up more pores. As your sticky little fingers poke and prod at that maturing pimple, you're actually forcing the debris and bacteria even deeper into the skin. This can cause an even bigger inflammatory response and make that original zit even bigger. This is how popping a pimple can cause scarring. Unless it's on your nose, then it can cause death. There's really no safe time to pop a pimple, but there are safer ways to do it. You'll need a special tool called a comedone extractor, which looks like this. Simply put the zit in the middle of the metal loop and press down as hard as you can, forcing that yummy pimple jelly to come shooting out. This is the slowly solidifying sebum and other oils, along with a bunch of germs and dirt all baked together inside the zit into a nice jam easily spreadable on toast for your eating pleasure. Getting as much of that pimple jam out is key in preventing the situation from getting worse. Leaving some in could lead to the pimple remaining clogged, and while it might deflate temporarily, it'll soon fill back up with more oils, bacteria, and debris, coming back even harder than before. But pop the wrong zit and you could die. Dubbed the triangle of death, zits that grow along the nasal bridge down to the corners of your mouth are best left alone. The dangers come from the threats we outlined before, risk of pushing bacteria deeper into the skin and causing an infection. Along this triangle of death, blood vessels that run directly to the brain are concentrated, and introduction of particularly deadly bacteria can lead to meningitis, an infection of the tissues around the brain and the spinal cord, or cavernous sinus thrombosis, a clot that prevents blood from reaching the brain. Now check out Why the Sun Hates You with What Actually Happens When You Get a Sunburn, or click this other video instead.